Hey everyone, this is Nick, and I am going to show you how to create this horizontal bar chart with these individual benchmark lines. It's a little bit more tricky than putting benchmark lines into a vertical bar chart or a column chart. So we're going to have to do a little bit of Excel hacking on the back end, and this is a live chart in PowerPoint. So you can see these are my ratings, this is my label, these are my benchmark labels right here, and we have this label right here. So I'm going to go over here to my extra slide. We've already put in a beautiful bar chart right here. I'm going to have to go in and we're going to have to edit some of the source data. So we're going to right click, edit data, and you can see that I've already entered some of the data that I want to enter. So I have my all visitor benchmark data. You're just going to add that here into your bar chart. And then we're also going to add this Y value column, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, in backwards order of how it shows up here on my chart. So number, however many options you have here, welcoming is number 5, and accessible here for me is number 1. So we've already added that on the back end, and now I'm going to show you how I add these benchmarks in. So we're going to have to first go into the chart design tools and go to select data. Right here you see I only have my first time visitor series selected. We're going to add a new series of data, and I'm going to add the all visitor benchmark right here. We're going to go ahead and do that. And once I do that, we will see that data pop up here. But now this is a clustered bar chart. I really want it to be those dots. And so to do that, we have to actually use a combo chart and we have to use a scatter plot on the back end to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the change chart type here. Go down to the combo chart option, and you see here my two series of data. I'm going to go ahead and click on the all visitor benchmark and put that on the secondary axis, and we're going to make that a scatter plot right here. Go all the way down to this scatter plot option there. And then my first time visitors, I don't want that to be a vertical column. I want that to be a horizontal, so we're going to make sure that that is a horizontal bar right there. I'm going to click OK, and things are going to look a little weird for a hot second. So let's go ahead, and what we now need to do is set these benchmarks, the all visitor benchmark, to a different level here. So what we're going to do is click on select data, and I need to edit where that all visitor benchmark data is coming from. The name is we're right over here, this cell right here, all visitor benchmark. The X values are going to be this data right here, that visitor benchmark data. The Y values are going to come from this extra column of Y that we did right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're going to click on enter and click OK. And once I click OK here, now you can see it's starting to take shape. I'm going to go ahead and just close out of the embedded Excel workbook. You can see my benchmarks now are right here, and I'm actually going to format the data series. I'm going to format those markers so that they're larger so you can see them. Let's go all the way up to say 20. This is a really big one right here. And then the fill color, I'm just going to make black so that you can really easily see it. It pops really nicely. But you see that they're kind of below, they're sort of like below the bar. We want them to be in the middle of the bar. In order to do that, we edit the secondary axis right here. You can see it goes from 0 to 6. We're going to change that to 0.5 to 5.5. So down here in the minimum, up here in the minimum, I'm going to say 0.5. There you go. And once I do that, you can see they come up into the middle of the bars. Now I'm going to go ahead and turn this white so that we don't have to see that secondary axis anymore. We don't need it. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a little embedded legend here. I'm going to highlight this one bar, right click, format data point. We're going to go over to, let's see if I can, or actually I think I have to do add data label. Here's my data label here. I'm going to go ahead and select that. We're going to put that above, and then I'm going to say get rid of the Y value and say series name, check series name. And so that is my all visitor benchmark there. And I can go up here, I can edit the text, I can edit the fonts. Let's see, I can make it bigger, and I can make it black right there so that it looks really nice. Very nice. Now, in my other version, I actually had a little label here that said first time visitor. So this was de designating this gray bar as my first time visitor, and the black circle is my benchmark. So I can actually just put a text box over this if I wanted to, or I could try to embed this into my chart as well. So let's go ahead and right click the chart. I'm going to say edit data, and I'm just going to go out over here and add a couple little series here. I'm going to say first time visitors. And then I'm going to say 0% in this, and then I'm going to put 5, the number 5 here. Now, once I do that, that's been added to my source data, and I'm going to go up here again to the chart design tab, and oops, I'm going to close out of that. The chart design tab, I'm going to select data, And then I'm going to add a series. Series name, I'm going to point to first time visitor. My x value, I'm going to go ahead to 0. And then my y value, I'm going to go ahead to 5. Point there, push enter, push OK, push OK again, get rid of this. Now you can see I have this little data marker right here at 0. And all I'm going to do is add a data label, right click to add the label. I'm going to highlight the actual label right there. And then I'm going to make sure that it is the y value is unchecked and the series name is selected. Now it says first time visitors. I'm going to go back to the, or actually right here up to the home tab, I can go ahead and update this text. Let's make it bold and white, maybe increase 16, maybe even bigger. I'm going to go over here to that size and properties menu and just make sure that the under alignment, this wrap text shape is unselected so that it doesn't wrap to two lines. And then I can go back here, select the data, the actual data marker. We don't need that. So I'm going to go ahead and under this, the marker formatting tool over here, I'm going to go ahead and say none so that it's going to get rid of it. And so now we have this beautiful horizontal bar chart that gives us an average benchmark or an all data benchmark in comparison to a single bar. In this case, it's first time visitor satisfaction ratings compared to all of my visitor satisfaction ratings. So I hope you like this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up. Make sure to subscribe to my channel for updates on data design, Excel, and PowerPoint tutorials. I appreciate all the likes and all the subscribes. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you next time.